What's happening?
Dan, he just appeared. He wants me to go with him. I think I better do as he says.
People outside, Daniel. Police. Lori, wait.
It'll be okay, Dan, really. You take care.
Hammering now. Best hurry. Lori, stop. Do you like it? Lori? Lori, what's... Oh, of course, please forgive me. Sometimes these things slip my mind.
Jesus, John, you stupid bastard, you...
Lori, are you all right?
Of course I'm not all right. I'm throwing up. You know, I always throw up whenever you take me anywhere. Oh, shit. I'm on Mars.
Of course. It is here on Mars that we debate Earth's destiny.
John, please. I mean, this. Just... being here, it's giving me problems, okay? I can't take your predestination trip right now.
Why does my perception of time distress you?
When I left you, when Nova Express attacked you, you were surprised. Why? If you knew it would happen.
Everything is preordained, even my responses.
And you just go through the motions, acting them out? Is that what you are? The most powerful thing in the universe, and you're just a puppet following a script?
We're all puppets, Lori. I'm just a puppet who can see the strings. We shall go up to the balcony. You can see the Notus Gordi Mountains from there.
Well, what if I don't? What happens if I just stay down here and screw all your predictions, huh? What happens then? John?
This is where we hold our conversation. It commences when you surprise me with the information that you and Dryburgh have been sleeping together.
You know about me and Dan?
No, not yet. But in a few moments, you're going to tell me.
John, what are you trying to do to me? When you're like this, I can't even talk to you, let alone debate the... what was it?
Destiny of the world.
Destiny of the world. This is ridiculous. Why hold a debate when you already know the goddamn outcome?
Because
that's how it happens. I know. Listen, John, okay. I'll play it your way. But you have to help me understand. I mean, I can't tell the future.
There is no future. There is no past. Do you see? Time is simultaneous, an intricately structured jewel that humans insist on viewing one edge at a time when the whole design is visible in every facet. What is your earliest memory?
Huh? My earliest memory? I don't know. Around when my folks split up, I guess. I can remember a toy, one of those snowstorm balls, but no, it's gone.
It isn't gone. It's still here. Let yourself see it.
Well, I was five, something like that. I must have got woken up. There was shouting downstairs. My mom and dad, God, I can hear them now. Shouted at him. He looked surprised. Couldn't imagine why I'd bear a grudge. And I just couldn't sustain it. The anger.
God, you know, really, you need analysis. I'm serious.
How would you know how a woman feels? Shit, how a man feels for that matter.
Oh, that's cheap, even for you. That is cheap.
You wanted to hear, so okay, you listen. First off, he was there, right? Plus he was gentle. You know what gentleness means in a guy like that? Even a glimmer of it? It means you reach some of that magical romance and bullshit that they promise you when you're a kid. It also means a broken marriage, an uncertain future for our child. My child. That's what all this is about, remember? Don't you worry about her future. That's taken care of. Nobody knew I was there. These moments were just mine. Everything felt secret and enchanted. And there was this toy. This snowstorm ball with a tiny castle inside. It was like a little glass bubble of somewhere else. I knew it wasn't real snow, but I couldn't understand how it fell so slowly. I figured inside the ball was some different sort of time. Slow time. And then...
Laurel Jane?
Oh?
What are you doing down here?
What, Larry? Don't you dare take this out on her. She's only a kid. She's vulnerable. Fragile. And inside, there was only water. My dad yelled and sent me to bed. He was always yelling, probably because he knew I wasn't his. My real dad, I'm pretty sure, was Mom's old boyfriend, who did justice.
I see. Then your mother's husband wasn't... Ah, look over there. A dust storm rising.
Yeah, very nice. No, Schexnader wasn't anything except a domineering bully. He really used to pick on me. That's probably why I'm edgy in relationships with strong, forceful guys. I mean, with Dan, it isn't like that. As a lover, he's more sort of receptive.
You mean that you're sleeping with Dryberg?
But you already know. I mean, you said...
I said often that you were my only link, my only concern with the world. When you left me, I left Earth. Does that not say something? Now you have replaced me, and that link is shattered. Don't you see what that means? Don't you see the futility of asking me to save a world that I no longer have any stake in?
John, don't be ridiculous. Earth's too important to hinge on one relationship.
Not to me. My red world here means more to me than your blue one. I will show you around it if you wish.
Oh, no. I've had enough of that. Throwing up and you forgetting I need to breathe. I'm not doing any more hopping around.
As you please.
I need a drink. What's in the bottle?
What do you want to be in the bottle?
What do... water. Just water.
As you wish.
John, I just can't take this. Sightseeing on Mars, drinking instant water, when down there the missiles could be flying right now. Humanity is about to become extinct. Doesn't that bother you? All those people dead?
All that pain and conflict done with? All that needless suffering over at last? No, no, that doesn't bother me. All those generations of struggle, what purpose did they ever achieve? All that effort, and what did it ever lead to?
I enjoy reminiscing every once in a while, but what's the point? All those years, we worked our asses off, but what did we achieve?
Well, I'm proud of what I achieved. I'm sitting in it. And as for what I achieved it with, I'm sitting on it.
Uh-oh. Better clean up your act, Sal. We got company.
Ah, she's heard it all before. Hi there, Sugar Tush. How'd the workout go? You gonna be a big, tough, super lady like Mom? Yeah, I guess. Atta girl. Now, let me see. Uncle Hollis, you know. But this big hunk over here, this is your Uncle Nelson. You've seen the picture. Oh, yeah, Captain Metropolis. You were skinnier back then.
Ah, well, listen, Sally, I'd better go check outside. He should arrive soon, and I promised I'd meet him. Hi there, Pumpkin. So, did you read my book yet?
Book?
Sure, Under the Hood. I gave Sally one to pass on.
I didn't give it to her yet. I figured she's young. She don't want to read that old stuff. Maybe when you're older. Mom, I'm 13. Why can't I read Uncle Hollis's book? I do all this training to be a costume hero. I can't even read about them.
Now, honey, maybe Mom knows best. I guess I wasn't thinking.
Well, I just guess you weren't.
Hey, everybody! Look who made the reunion after all.
Byron! Oh, Byron, it's so good to see you. Can we fix you a...
Just a club soda for Mr. Lewis.
My friends! Oh, my friends! What time is it?
High time we all got together, is what it is. Here's your soda, Byron.
Mom, who? Shh! An old friend. I'll explain later. Jesus! Is that what I'm training for? What I got to look forward to? Lori, shut up. Byron's fine. He just...
I'm just sorry. I'm sorry for us all. Byron, careful. Your glass, you're spilling everything.
Lori, are you listening to me? I was asking the point of all that struggling. The purpose of this endless labor, accomplishing nothing, leaving people empty and disillusioned, leaving people broken.
Okay, I'll admit lots of people have messed up lives that don't accomplish anything visible, but don't we have some importance beyond that? I mean, just the existence of life, isn't that significant?
In my opinion, it's a highly overrated phenomenon. Mars gets along perfectly without so much as a microorganism. See, there's the South Pole beneath us now. No life, no life at all. But giant steps, 90 feet high, scoured by dust and wind into a constantly changing topographical map, flowing and shifting around the pole in ripples 10,000 years wide. Tell me, would it be greatly improved by an oil pipeline?
John, in those terms, sure, mankind hasn't helped the environment. But against that, you have to measure the lives of artists, scientists, poets. Hell, even my life. That has to be worth something. Without life, there wouldn't even be an environment.
Your definition is narrow. Life insisting on life's viewpoint when alternatives exist. Those jumbled box canyons below, where volcanoes boiled the permafrost into scalding geysers, once they could have been fountains of life. The ground crumbled when the subterranean ice melted, releasing torrents of water to form vast rivers, now long dry. Life could have flourished here then, but Mars did not choose life. It chose this. It's called chaotic terrain.
Yeah, well, ordinary life, my life, that's got chaotic terrain too. I mean, you're so fascinated by rocks getting twisted into weird shapes. Jesus Christ, you should have seen me before I met you. My mother, she eroded my adolescence, chipping me into the shape she'd have been if she hadn't had me. She pushed me into adventuring, fussing over my career, trying to live her life through me. Remember the Crime Busters thing in the 60s? Did I tell you she drove me there in a limo and waited outside like it was my first screen test or something? I was 16. I felt like a jerk. I remember staring at you. I just couldn't get used to you. I mean, you had a great body, but, you know, it was blue. Your girlfriend, Janie, she glared at me all the way through. Then it collapsed. Everybody leaving, except Nelson and Adrian. Big disappointment. Outside, I watched them go. I felt let down, restless, horny, and I needed a cigarette. I was leaving Nelson's mansion, and somebody called my name.
Laurel? Laurel Jane, is that right? So, you're Sally's kid.
Yeah. I caught your act in there. You were pretty cool.
Well, you don't look like you grew up too bad yourself. Here, let me take a look. Yeah, there's her eyes. You even got that funny little mole. You ain't got her hair, but otherwise, you're like her. You're a looker.
I need a cigarette, but I don't have a light. Do you?
Sure. Hey, listen. Your mom, she talk about me much?
No, not much.
It figures. Here's your light. Hell, on out. Here, let me.
You take your hands off her!
Hi, Sal. Long time no see.
Not long enough in my book, Eddie. Laurel Jane, you put that thing out and come here immediately. We're going home. And as for you, are there no depths you won't sink to?
Christ, we were just talking. And a guy talked to his, you know, his old friend's daughter? I mean, what do you think I am?
I know what you are, Edward Blake. I've known what you were for 25 years, and don't you ever forget that. Get in the car, Lori.
Sally, listen. I thought we'd settled that a long time ago.
No, things like that don't ever get settled. Not completely. And they're not going to happen to my daughter.
We drove away in silence. He looked sad. I felt sorry for him. Of course, then I didn't know what the bastard had done. We drove 3 blocks, and then she pulled the car over and just sat there, and it all came pouring out. Her pain, her fears, her whole life, you know? I mean, ordinary people, right? All the things that happened to them. Doesn't that move you more than a bunch of rubble?
No. I read Adams, Laurie. I see the ancient spectacle that birthed the rubble. Beside this, human life is brief and mundane.
Oh, I give up. This is just rounded circles. Can't you tell me how this conversation ends and spare me the agony?
It ends with you in tears. Look there. Olympus Mons approaches.
Tears? You mean I lose?
You mean you don't come back to Earth?
I return to Earth at some point in my future. There are streets full of corpses. The details are vague.
No. Oh, no, John. What do you mean, vague? There's gonna be a war? A real war? Oh, God.
I'm not sure. There's some sort of static obscuring the future, preventing any clear impression. The electromagnetic pulse of a mass warhead detonation might conceivably cause that.
Oh, no.
Beyond that, events grow even sketchier. I am standing in deep snow. I am killing someone. Their identity is uncertain. Look at it. A volcano as large as Missouri. Breathtaking.
Breathtaking? John, what about the war? You've got to prevent it. Everyone will die.
And the universe will not even notice. We've been through this before, Lori. You argued that human life was more significant than this excellent desolation, and I was not convinced. You attempted to compare the mere uncertainty in your existence with the chaos of the world beneath us. But where are the pinnacles to rival this Olympus? Where are the depths to match those of... Ah, but we near the Valles Marineris. You may see for yourself. It stretches more than 3,000 miles, so that one end knows day while the other endures night. Temperature differences breed shrieking winds that herd oceans of fog along a canyon 4 miles deep. Does the human heart know chasms so abysmal?
Yes. Yes, mine, right now. John, you've seen people depressed. Me, when I'm miserable, when I've had too much to drink.
Yes, I remember a banquet in 1973.
Oh, don't remind me. I acted like an idiot. But I guess that's in keeping with the rest of my life, huh? I mean, you say it's all worthless, right? That we're all blind, stupid things stumbling through our lives, hopelessly lost in the fog. The fog I was lost in that night was Scotch mist. I must have drunk half a bottle. It was a dinner in honor of Blake. I remember thinking, why? Why all this sudden popularity? Nixon wasn't there, but everybody else was. Ford, Liddy, Al Haig. Ford shook Blake's hand. Everybody seemed real pleased with him, but not me. See, by then I'd read Under the Hood about him assaulting my mom. That banquet, it was the first time I'd seen him since I found out. And I was mean drunk. See those Post reporters they found in that garage? Woodward and what's his name? Jewish name. Bernstein. Yeah, I understand the underground papers are already yelling conspiracy. Well, Eddie, any opinions? That piece in the Berkeley Barb. Well, I guess you smoke enough weed, you can imagine almost anything. Nah, I'm clean, guys. Just don't ask where I was when I heard about JFK. That's good. Dick'll love that. Miss Uspechik, good to see you.
Uspechik, what's that? Grandmother's name? Didn't like Jupiter, huh? Didn't take your old man's name either.
What's my name to you?
Nothing. You know, you're a pretty girl. I just gotta look at you. I see your mom. You know, your mother, she was a peach.
Is that what you told her before you tried to rape her? Before you hit her? Before you kicked her? That isn't the way you treat peaches?
Kid, are you sure you want to take this all the way?
Damn straight I do. I mean, what kind of man are you? You have to take some woman? You have to force her into having sex against her will?
Only once.
Only once. As if, you know, it was better than doing it twice or 50 times. And his scar. It always looked like he was sneering. Had 7 scotches inside me, 1 in my hand, and I let him have it. And then you came, and you were angry, and you took me home. It was the first time you ever teleported me anywhere. First time I threw up. But I mean, why bother telling you all this? It just confirms things, right? All these wretched, grubby little human encounters. Better off without them. None of it ever meant a damn thing anyway. I mean, these, my mother's clippings, her whole life, right there. What's it mean? In your terms, next to a neutrino, next to something you can't even see, for Christ's sake, it means nothing.
Lori.
Don't Lori me. It's pointless debating when you obviously don't see anything terribly miraculous in life. Maybe quantum physics doesn't allow miracles.
No. Thermodynamic miracles are...
Oh, for God's sake, John. Just land this thing. Now.
As you wish.
You can take me back to Earth to fry with Dan and my mom and all us other worthless humans. The conversation's over.
And listen, you were wrong, see? You said it ended with me in tears, and look at me. Not a moist eye in sight. You were wrong about that. Maybe about a lot of things. I mean, maybe you were wrong about the streets full of corpses, too. John, can you hear me?
Perfectly.
Oh, Jesus, John.
Lori, you complain, perhaps rightly, that I won't see existence in human terms, but you yourself refuse to consider my viewpoint, letting your emotions blind you. Look at yourself, angry, shouting.
Shouted at him. He looked surprised. Couldn't imagine why I'd bear a grudge. And I just couldn't sustain it, the anger.
If you'd only relax enough to see the whole continuum, life's pattern or lack of one, then you'd understand my perspective. You're deliberately shutting out understanding as if you're afraid, as if you're too delicate.
Mom, I'm 13. Why can't I read Uncle Hollis's book? I do all this training to be a costume hero. I can't even read about them.
Now, honey, maybe Mom knows best. I guess I wasn't thinking.
I'm through thinking about my life, looking back on all my stupid memories. It's been a dumb life, and if there's any design, it's a dumb design. I don't want to see it. I don't want to talk about it.
Christ, we were just talking. And a guy talked to his, you know, his old friend's daughter. I mean, what do you think I am?
I think you're avoiding something.
Don't be stupid. There's nothing to avoid.
No. His old friend's daughter.
What do you think I am? I've never had any occasion to avoid the truth.
Only once.
His old friend's daughter? And a guy talked to his old friend's daughter?
I mean, look here. My life, my mom's life, there's nothing there worth avoiding. It's all just meaningless.
You know, his old friend's daughter?
Talk about no. His old friend's daughter. No. No, not him. Not. No.
You know.
No. No, she wouldn't. She couldn't have. Not after
he.
She
couldn't sustain it. The anger I think I am.
No.
Talking.
No, you're not. You're not.
Lori.
You're not my father. My father.
You think I am? And a guy talked to his, you know, his daughter.
No! And there was this toy, this snowstorm ball, with a tiny castle inside. It was like a little glass bubble of somewhere else. I knew it wasn't real snow, but I couldn't understand how it fell so slowly. I figured inside the ball was some different sort of time. Slow time. And inside, there was only water.
Lori, are you all right?
Of course not. Blake, that bastard, and my mother, they pulled a gag on me is what they did. My whole life's a joke. One big, stupid, meaningless. Oh, shit.
I don't think your life is meaningless.
Oh, no? Well, obviously, that's what you're going to say, because anything I'm stupid enough to believe is true, you just disagree with it, and, you don't?
No.
But listen, you've just been saying life is meaningless. So how can...
I changed my mind.
But why?
Thermodynamic miracles. Events with odds against so astronomical they're effectively impossible. Like oxygen spontaneously becoming gold. I long to observe such a thing. And yet in each human coupling, 1,000 million sperm vie for a single egg. Multiply those odds by countless generations against the odds of your ancestors being alive, meeting, siring this precise son, that exact daughter, until your mother loves a man she has every reason to hate, and of that union, of the 1,000 million children competing for fertilization, it was you, only you, that emerged. To distill so specific a form from that chaos of improbability, like turning air to gold, that is the crowning unlikelihood, the thermodynamic miracle.
But if my birth, if that's a thermodynamic miracle, I mean, you could say that about anybody in the world.
Yes, anybody in the world. But the world is so full of people, so crowded with these miracles that they become commonplace, and we forget. I forget. We gaze continually at the world and it grows dull in our perceptions. Yet seen from another's vantage point, as if new, it may still take the breath away. Come, dry your eyes, for you are life, rarer than a quark, and unpredictable beyond the dreams of Heisenberg, the clay in which the forces that shape all things leave their fingerprints most clearly. Dry your eyes, and let's go home.